Hi everyone, in the last class we have seen the concept of CSS animations, which are meant for smooth changing of properties from one set of properties to another set of properties without triggering. So this is the only difference between CSS animations and CSS transitions, right? You know, in CSS transitions, which is also meant for to change from one set of properties to another set of properties, but the thing is here we require some kind of triggering. We need to push from outside. Whereas coming to CSS animations, we no need to push anything from the externally. Okay, fine. In today's class, we'll see the concept of flexbox, which is very, very important. Nowadays, every web developer, every user interface developer is using the concept of flexbox while developing any kind of website. Because with the help of this flexbox, I can able to design a flexible layout. Meaning that where I need to arrange the elements in the web page. For example, I would like to place my header in the top section, navigation in the side section, footer in the bottom section, like that. You can able to decide at which location I need to place my element. We can able to design that effectively with the help of flexbox. Generally, we can able to design a flexible layout with the help of other concepts also, like float, clear, width. With the help of all this, we can able to design a flexible layout. But the thing is, with the help of flexbox, we can able to design this layout very much easier. Very much easier. Meaning that we can able to design a layout within a less time, and we can able to complete that task quickly. And also, it is more flexible. The name itself provides, it is more flexible. Yeah. So generally, meaning is, you know, nowadays, whatever the website that we are developing, that website is going to open in various kind of gadgets or various kind of devices, you know, right? All the customers are using mobile phones, and some customers are using some kind of tablets. Some customers are using laptops, like that. Different type of customers are using different kind of devices, so that these devices should support our website more effectively, so that these customers won't leave our website quickly if the content is also good. Yeah. Meaning that, finally, what I would like to say is, if I am going to develop a particular website, that particular website should be more responsive in all the devices, in all kind of devices. Okay. So if you want to develop that kind of more responsive website, we'll go for the concept of flexbox. Clearly, I am saying that we can able to design that thing with the help of some other concepts also, but with the help of flexbox, I can able to design it within less time, and we can able to design easily. Able to design easily. Yeah. Fine. Okay. Before going to dive into this flexbox concept, let me take one example where we can able to design a flexible layout with the help of normal flexbox also. But the thing is, we need to write some extra code. Okay, fine. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take some division. I'm going to give some class name as left container, and I'm going to take some name, lorem ipsum, some data I have taken, some text I have taken. Yeah, fine. I'm going to take one more division, class equal to something like write container. Okay, once I execute, you can able to understand this one clearly. Yeah, fine. So what my requirement is, here observe, if you execute this, observe what happened here. So left container is displaying the first, later on the right container is displaying. But my requirement is, I would like to get the divide the web page into two parts. The left side contains some para, right side contains some para. If you want to make it that kind of arrangement to all my elements, we need to manage with the help of a code, right? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to access that code. So for example, I would like to access that left container, and I'm going to make the help of float. I'm going to make it arrange to the left side. And is there any change? No. Now I will make modify to right container. Container float towards right side. Observe, is there any change? No, because we didn't set this width, because by default this is a kind of division tag. So division tag is a kind of block level element, so it is going to occupy the entire width as much as available over the website or the browser. Yeah, fine. So that is the reason I am going to fix my width of this division tab. Yeah. For example, I am going to take it is 40%. Now you can observe. Yes, fine. It will look. What about this division? So to make this to the right side also, I need to make set this width also. Yeah. For example, width equal to 60%. Observe, guys. Yeah, like this you can able to arrange the data. Yeah, for example, I would like to make some kind of border, 1 pixel solid red color. Border 1 pixel solid red color. Now you can observe some difference. I hope you already know this concept. Yeah, because so calculating the width of an element includes margins, paddings, and all the remaining things are like element width, all those it is going to calculate, right? Here the first element width is 40%, second element width is 60%, so total 100% of the browser is completed already. What about this border, margin, padding, all those amount of space? So it is going to include it. That is why this entire space doesn't include in a single at one particular stretch. So that is why it is taking to the next line and aligned to the right side. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take it to some 37%. So instead of this, you can go for border box. I hope you know that meaning. Yeah. So like this, you can able to arrange. Yeah. Fine. For example, I would like to add one more division. For example, I'm taking it as another container. I will access that. Dot another container. I will access that. So observe, guys. Now you can understand from where it is going to get, from the starting of the second division. Now if you want to make it remove this all the things, we need to use clear property and we need to use some float property, all this we got to do. But so it takes some kind of hectic code. So instead of that, we can go for with the help of a flex box. It is a very easy thing. Yeah. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to define, so instead of making it float to the right side, I'm going to define it as float to the left side. Go to the left side so that it is like this. You have to, yeah. For example, I would like to define some border 1 pixel solid red color. Like this, you can design this layout. For example, I'm trying to minimize. Is it flexible? Yes, of course it is flexible, because we have defined width as in the form of percentages, meaning that it is going to define with respect to parent size, it is going to make it response. Fine. The same thing we can do with the help of flexbox code. Okay, fine. Instead of going for writing all these float, width, all these things, we can go for do it with help of flexbox. Yeah, what I am going to do is let me show that example first. Later I will dive into the concept. Yeah. So for example, I am taking this class as some parent, and this is a kind of division. I am going to take the class as a div1. I'm going to take one more class called div2. That's called as div2. Yeah. Observe, guys. If I refresh, what happened? Again, it looked like the same thing as like as a previous example score. Yeah. They are going. Now, I would like to get in the form of the same pattern what I explained. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to access this parent instead of writing all this code. I will apply the concept of flexbox. So you won't understood this right now, but thing is I would like to show this is also we can do with the help of flexbox. Yeah. What I'm going to do is I'm going to simply make display as flex. Yeah, there are some properties for display which I already know. So observe, guys, what happened here? It is simply divided into two parts, meaning that block level elements converted into inline elements, and it is going to take the required amount of space. So for example, I am going to take some kind of a margin 5 pixel, and I am going to take some kind of a background color as white. Observe. Yeah, fine. If you want to make flexibly arrange all those, I would like to take division 1. Yeah, I am going to take background color as violet. Don't worry, why it has done like that. I will explain that later part of the session. I will go with the indigo libgr format. Yeah, observe, guys. So now you can understand, right? It is how much flexible? Yes, you can minimize. It is going to do like this. It is also more flexible. Like this, we can do a flexible website with the help of flexbox. Yeah, fine. So let me go for dive into the concept. Yeah, so before going to dive into this concept, actually we are having various kind of layout modules that we have already seen in the previous classes. One type of layout module is block layout module, inline layout module, table layout module, position layout module. These are all the various kind of layout modules which are meant for to arrange the elements in the layout. Yeah, so block level layout module, which is meant for especially for to arrange sections in a web page. Yeah, so inline is meant for to arrange the text in a web page, and whereas coming to table, which is meant for to arrange the 2D data, meaning that if you want to arrange data in the form of rows and columns, we'll go for table layout module. Yeah, coming to position, which is meant for to define the explicit position of an element, then we'll go for position layout module. Yeah, so and one more kind of layout module right now which we are seeing, flexbox. There is one more kind of layout module that is also latest one, gridbox. Yeah, so before going to gridbox, let me go with the flexbox. Yeah. Fine. So with the help of this flexbox, there are some kind of advantages are there. Meaning that we can able to simply distribute the space around the elements. Okay. If you didn't understood this statement right now, you can understood while executing the example. Yeah. We can able to control the element alignments. Like where I need to place the element, position, etc. Yeah. Similarly, we can able to control the order of elements also. For example, you can observe this example so that I will get clear idea. Yeah. Order equal to 2. I am going to define. So for your understandability, I am taking here it as order 2. Another one is nothing. You can change right now. What happened in the previous execution? This para is comes to the first division and this para is in the second division. Right now I change the order or not? Yes. This kind of thing also we can do simply with the help of this flexbox. So finally what I am saying is with the help of this flexbox concept, we can able to design a more flexible and efficient layout. Yeah, fine. I will take next slide. So from here onwards, it is very, very important to make it clear understanding of this flexbox concept. If you take a flexbox, this flexbox contains importantly two things. One is flex container. Another one is flex item. These are the two technical terms you need to understand first. Yeah. So flex container means it contains some information. So you know the meaning of this one. Flex container contains some data. Some data can be, we call it as any kind of data. Yeah. Flex items means these are the child items. These are the child items of the flex container. Like if you take a simple example, let me consider this is a kind of division. If I call this as a flex container, whatever the things that are present inside this flex container, these are all called as flex item. If you take this example, yeah, I will modify some code so to make it clear for you. I will take some padding so that you can visualize that padding 30 pixel. Yeah, fine guys. You can observe guys here, the flex container is the white background. Flex container is white background. In that, this violet and indigo colors represents flex items. Color represents flex item. Yeah, that is what I would like to explain here. So, fine. Yeah. So, if you want to use this flexbox model, first you need to define the flex container. You need to define the flex container. How we are going to define the flex container? By simply making use of the property called display property. With the help of display property, I can able to convert a division or any kind of container into a flex container. So before going to that like flex container, in the previous classes, we have seen various kind of properties for the display. One is inline property, inline value, block value, none value, inline block. These are all the things which we have seen in the previous classes. Meaning that this is also meant for kind of layout arrangements, right? So that is what I said here. Yeah. Fine. So these are all the sum of values supported by this display property. In addition to all this, which you already discussed in the previous classes, if we write display equal to flex, meaning that now this particular division will act as a flex container, meaning that which is more flexible for to design layout of a particular website. Okay, fine. So I have created this flex container. For this flex container, I can able to add more properties. Like with the help of these properties, I can able to improve these features, right? Yeah, fine. So what are those properties I can do is, one kind of thing is, so first let me go for first normal property. One is display equal to flex. If I made the display equal to flex, what is the meaning of this one is, it is going to convert all the block level elements into a particular displaying order. That particular displaying order in the form of either row or a form of column, or in the form of a column. Yeah. Guys, I hope you understood this one. So how these divisions are arranged here? These divisions are arranged in the form of row wise. If you would like to arrange the data in the form of column wise, you can able to arrange that. Yeah. Why that particular code arranged in the form of row? Because that is the default one. Row arrangement of elements is the default one. That is why it displayed in the form of row order. If you want to go for a column, you can go for with the help of these special properties. Meaning that with the help of display equal flex, I can able to convert all the block level elements into a particular order in the form of either row wise or column wise. And also the advantage is, even though we increase the browser size, or if we decrease the browser size, your content won't loss. So it will stretch as much as possible. It will decrease the size as much as possible also. Meaning is, you can go for like this. It will decrease as much as possible. it increase as much as possible. Yeah, that is, so it like a more flexible. Yeah, fine. So what I will do is I will go the execution part parallelly along with the explanation part. Yeah. So instead of going this example, I will take the another one. I refresh, nothing is there. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create one division. Yeah, I'm sorry. I am writing in CSS code. Yeah. Division. Yeah. Class equal to, I'm taking the name itself as a flex container. Itself as a flex container. Yeah. Fine. In that, I would like to define various kind of flex items. Flex items called as a flex item 1 plus flex item 1. I am going to name the first flex item 1. Yeah, I am going to copy the multiple times. Yeah. Fine. So this naming as flex item 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. 6, 5. Fine guys, if you observe here, what happened here, all are going to arrange in the form of block level elements, right? Yeah. So if you know the meaning, right? Division is a kind of block level element. Yeah. So I'm going to access this flex container. Flex container, I would like to apply some kind of set of things, like I would like to set the margin around the flex container as 5 pixel, and I'm going to take the padding also 30 pixel, and my background color is white color, as you know. Yeah. Observe guys. Now the white border shows a flex container. What about the flex items, the data which is printed inside this? So for that also I would like to set some properties so that it look for me explanation is good. Flex item one, I would like to arrange the margin as 5 pixel, and my background color I would like to change as violet color. I am going to follow WebGR property. I hope 6 is completed. Yeah, flex item 1, flex item 2, color is indigo, blue, 3, 4, next WebGR, right, green color, flex item 5, yellow, flex item 6, so I won't write orange because background color is itself orange. I will go for with the red. Now observe, yes. How about the flex item 5? Yellow color, why it is not applied? Yeah, spelling mistake. Yes. So now the colors which we are getting here as flex items, and the background color white is displayed as a flex container, meaning that flex container contains the items. If I resize, it automatically resizes. There is no problem at all. If I stretch, there is no problem at all. Yeah, fine. So this is the use of display equal to flex. There is one more property, there is one more value supported this one, which is inline flex. So what happened here is, this container, if I write like display equal to inline flex, this container will act as an inline element. What is the meaning of this one? Inline element means it is going to occupy the space, the amount which is required, and also it won't respond for various kind of devices. I hope I understood the meaning. Yeah, I will do this. So right now, from now onwards, I will go for with modification of only flex box. I'm sorry, I didn't explain this. So So this is general property of division. This is general property of division. If I made to convert into a flex box, I will go for display equal to flex. Display equal to flex. If I refresh, what happened? Automatically they are going to stretch into the required amount of space. They are going to arrange in the form of a particular order, row by row. Yeah. If I stretch, what happened? It is going to automatically align. Yeah. That is the advantage of this one. If I go for example, I would like to modify some data here. For example, instead of this, I will go for defining the width, so that you can understand the difference. Width as 100 pixel. This width as 200 pixel. I don't want for flex item 3 and flex item 4 and flex item 5. I would like to define the width as 150 pixel, and for this the width item as 150 pixel. Now you can observe, yeah, it varies the it applies those properties. Now if I resize, what happened? Automatically they are stretching as much as required, as much as less. Yeah, so meaning that it is flexible to your browser. Now if you observe, I would like to go for making it as 200 pixel, so that you can observe some more difference. Yes. Stretches towards the browser width. Yeah. Fine. So instead of this display equal to flex, I will go for display equal to inline flex. Yes. I will make it this comment. Now you can observe the difference. Refresh, there is no change as far as now. So if I am going to resize the browser, what happened here, guys? You can observe the content is outflowing, meaning that it is not responding with respect to the browser, meaning that it is going to take out the required amount of space. And observe, so in the previous display called flex, it is going to occupy the entire block, entire width of the space. So white color is observed up to here, but right now it is going to take only for up to the required amount of space. It is not responding. So content is hiding. So that is the difference between display equal to inline flex and a display equal to flex. Now, once I made a flex container, yeah, you can observe the difference. Now the background color white is completely occupied over the entire space. Yeah, fine. Now I designed a flex container. So with the help of display equal to flex or display equal to inline flex, for this flex container I can able to add more number of properties. Before that, we can go for defining some height for this one. For example, flex item 2, I am going to define the height as 100 pixel, and flex item 4, height also 100 pixel. Now you can observe, guys, here what happened? Automatically the flex container height is also changing, meaning that if the inline flex item height, if it is occupied some height, that same occupied height will be assigned to all the flex items in this container. For example, I'm modifying this to 200 pixel. One of the height has 200 pixel. What about the other one? All other ones will be changed to 200 pixel except this one, because for flex item 4, I have specifically mentioned its height as 100 pixel. And what about all other items? For all other items, height I didn't define. That is why it is going to take the large height from all the flex items. Yeah. If I made this as comment, automatically all will be assigned to the same height. Yeah. Meaning that here flex container height is 200 pixel. It will be applicable to all the flex items except the specifically defined flex items. Yeah, fine. So this is the way you are going to define the flex container. So we'll dive into further. Yeah, next kind of property, we call it as a flex direction property. So this flex direction property is going to define in which direction the container wants to stack the elements that I am going to define with the help of flex direction. Flex direction. By default, the container is going to place the items in the form of row wise. If you would like to place them in the form of column wise, I can able to place. If you would like to place in the form of row reverse, you can able to place with the help of row reverse value. If you would like to place in the form of column reverse, I can able to place in the form of column reverse. Yeah, fine. So I will go for using that property for this flex container. Yeah, fine. What I will do, I'll go for defining flex direction as row. Yeah. Is there any change? No, nothing changes. Instead of this, I'll go for column. Observe what happened. Arranging these all the elements in the form of column wise. Arranging all these elements in the form of column wise. If I go for column reverse, I have saved it. Observe now, flex item will comes under the bottom. It will arrange from the bottom to top. Bottom top. That is not the correct explanation. So, but I will explain with the help of diagram. Row reverse. What happened? In the form of control X, save. Yeah, row wise ordered. Now flex item is one is arranged from the left to right. Now it is arranged from the right to left. As well, like this, we can able to arrange all the items. So it is also flexible. Yeah. Fine. Now the concept here is you have to understand two important diagrams here. One is if I am going to define the flex direction as row, the elements are going to arrange start from cross axis as well as from main axis, meaning that main axis will look like this and cross axis will look like this, and the elements are going to start from this particular corner. If I am going to define this as row reverse, my main axis will look like the opposite thing. Main axis will look like from the right topmost corner, and cross axis will look like from the right topmost corner. This is what we call it as a cross axis. This diagram is very, very, very important to make it clear, understand. Yeah. If I made this as a column arrangement, main axis will comes under the y axis, and on x axis will get the cross axis. If I made this as column reverse, main axis will be on the x axis, but from the bottom to top, and this is a cross axis from bottom to right. Yeah, so if you understood this one, you can able to visualize this one clearly. Yeah, first I will modify once again the code. This as row. Observe guys, so it is going to start from the main axis as well as cross axis. So if I am defining it as row, so main axis starts from this corner, left side top corner. Yeah, main axis and cross axis. That is why the elements are arranged like this. If I made the thing as row reverse, what the diagram is showing? Main axis starts from right side top corner, cross axis starts from right side top corner. So from side the elements are going to arrange. Observe. That is why, if you refresh, from right side top corner, it is going to display like this. Yeah, fine. Similarly, column also, main axis will look like this and cross axis will look like this. From this corner, it is going to start. Observe. Now this is from top to bottom main axis. From top to right side, this is cross axis. That is why this is going to arrange it like this. Now column reverse. You can visualize that same thing in the form of reverse manner. So you can able to play with this all the code. Observe. Now main axis starts from bottom to top, bottom to right side. That is why the elements are arranged like. So this is the concept of flex direction. If you want, you can use specifically all those things. So I will go for the general thing for the sake of our examples. I am going for row. Next kind of property, flex wrap property. which is meant for whether flex item should wrap or not. Flex item should wrap or not, we can able to define with the help of flex wrap. For example, whenever we are going to decrease the size of browser, I am going to refresh this. Whenever we are going to decrease the size of browser, ultimately what is happening, it is stretching, it is not stretching, it is constraining. Congesting, adjusting to here only. But thing is, I don't want like that. I would like to have whenever we reach an element width as some size, for example, I have defined the flex item 5, flex item 6 as 200 pixel. Whenever it reaches to the element size as 200 pixel, I don't want to congest. I would like to make it wrap to the next line. Then I will go for flex wrap property. Here it supports various kind of values. One is wrap, another one is no wrap, this is by default. Another one is wrap reverse. Yeah, so by default it is no wrap. Observe. Yeah, I'll go for flex wrap. By default is no wrap. That is why there is no change, even though I minimized my browser. Yeah, fine. Instead of that, I will go for wrap. Now you can observe the difference. I'm going to refresh. Observe, whenever it reaches to the minimum width as 200 pixel, it won't congest there. It will come slightly to wrap to the next line. What about the flex item 5? If I minimize trying to like that, automatically it will also will do like that. Yes. Observe. If I go for like this. Yes. Fine. Now observe, guys. Here, as I have used the flex direction as row, it is going to arrange in the form of row wise. If I go for row reverse. Now observe, there is slight difference. Is there any change? Observe, whenever flex item 6 is reduced to 200 pixel, it is going to arrange from the right side. So because I have made them as a row reverse, so like this you can play with this flex box. Yeah, fine. I don't want this row reverse. Yeah, this is about wrap. If I go for one more kind of the thing, wrap reverse, meaning that it is just opposite to wrap property. So in wrap property, what happened here? Whenever I minimizes, generally it will comes to the next line. But in wrap reverse, it is going to towards the reverse side, on the top direction it will move. Yes. So this is the meaning of wrap reverse. In wrap, it will comes to the next line. In wrap reverse, it is going to the previous line. Wrap reverse is going to flow to the previous line. Yeah. Fine. Yeah. There is one kind of shorthand property is there. Which is meant for instead of writing this in two extra properties like flex direction and flex wrap, we have a property called flex flow property, which is a shorthand property for flex direction as well as flex wrap. Flex direction as well as flex wrap. Yeah, so it is going to accept two parameters, two values. One is flex direction, another one is flex wrap. If I go for writing a row as well as wrap, we can go for no wrap, like that you can play with this all the things. So instead of this thing, I will go for the same output to get. I will write like here, flex flow equal to, I will write the same as the above comments, row comma wrap reverse, because you can understood that. You can observe the same output with the help of that shorthand property. If I minimize, observe, it is going to go for up. If I go for simply wrap. It will comes to the next end because I made the code in such a way that row hyphen wrap. So you can play with all these. next kind of property, this kind of property align items property. Align items property. So this align items property, which is meant for to define the position of items, to define the position of all items in the container, to define the position of all items in the container relating to the cross axis. So I hope you know the meaning of cross axis as well as main axis. So relating them cross axis. So with respect to cross axis, if I would like to arrange the items in the container, then I will go for the property called align items property. It will support the various kind of values: stretch, center, flex start, flex end, baseline. Flex end, baseline. Yeah, fine. If you observe, assume that this is a container. This is a container. By default, all the items in the container are going to fill the container size. That is what we call it as stretch. Stretch. Center means this won't be stretch. These are going to be arranged in the form of a center with respect to cross axis. This is cross axis. If I go for defining it as a row, so with respect to cross axis, center is this one. So it will arrange the data like this. Observe. So I will go for wrap as well as all these things. Yeah, I have refreshed this. Fine. Modified the code as align items. Align items equal to, if I write like stretch, is there any change in the output? No change in the output, because by default the stretch is the default one. Yeah, it will work as it is similar. I'll go for center. Observe. So as I have written it as a row, the cross axis is on the y axis. So with respect to y axis, the center is this one. So it is going to take the required amount of space and is going to make it center. That is the advantage of these align items. Center, or I can go for flex start. Flex start. So meaning that it will go to the flex starting location. So this is the starting, meaning that this is the cross axis. Cross axis flex start is this one. This is flex end. This is center. If you go for cross axis this side. So I hope you can practice. If you go for cross axis this side, flex start is this side and flex end is this side. This is center. I think if I go with the column, you can visualize that clearly. Yeah. First, I'll go with the row wise. Observe. All are going to arrange in the form of flex start location. If I go with the end, it'll go with end also. All going to arrange in the form of end, because this flex item to height is 200 pixels, so it won't change. Yeah. So instead of that, I'll go for column wise. If I go for column wise, what is the expected output? Column wise, the main axis will be on the y axis, cross axis will be on the x axis from top to right side. So here what I have defined, yeah, flex end. So what happened, so on this side you will get, yes, observe. So like this you can modify this, all the things. So you can play all this, or I can go for a baseline. Go for a baseline. So baseline means, so these items are going to arrange with respect to their content, not with respect to, if I go for a row, you can visualize that clearly. These items are going to arrange with respect to the content, with respect to content, meaning that the data which is present in the items, the most letters which are at the same height, that kind of thing it is going to adjust. Yeah, fine. That is called as baseline. Yes, fine. So next kind of property, align content property. Align content property, which is meant for to align the content, with respect to the flex lines. With respect to flex lines, what do you mean flex lines? If I go for refresh and minimizing, what happened? This is the one kind of flex line. So first line is one kind of flex line, second line is one kind of flex line. So to make it that arrangement, then I can go for align content. Nafa align cutting. So how to align these flex lines? We can define with the help of align content. So that thing, so it is going to accept the values like it is going to accept like center or space between space around flex end. So I hope you understood now. So the first row is one kind of flex line, second row is one kind of flex line. You can visualize here itself. And if I made like center with respect to container, the next row also will be always adjusted in the center format. If I go for space between, it is going to define how it is going to define. It is going to provide the space between the one flex line to another flex line. If I go for space around, it is going to provide space around the each flex line. Flex start means it is always going to arrange the lines in the form of flex start. Flex start side it is going to arrange. Flex end means it is always going to arrange from the flex end onwards. Yeah. So you can understand this one with help of this one. Align content. I will made it as a center. Observe. If I refresh and if I minimizing, what happened? By default, it is adjusting towards the center side only. Yeah. Fine. So what I will do is I will define its height actually so that it looks good. 600 pixel. See, observe now. If I am going to minimize, how the content is adjusting? Center part of the web page. Am I right or not? Yeah. Fine. So instead of going for 600 pixel, we go with say 500 pixel. Yes. They are going to arrange in the center. I will go for defining space between. Refresh. What happened? By default, they are going to start from flex start. That is why what happened here. By default, it is going to arrange from the flex start. So this is the thing. You can observe. Yeah. Fine. Now what I am going to do is I am trying to minimize. You can observe if it splits to the next line, next flex line. What happened here? From one flex line to another flex line, the space is provided. Another space is provided. And there is no space around the flex line. This space is called as margin. Yeah, fine. If you observe the space around, I'm going to refresh. Yeah, fine. Around the flex line also, it is going to provide space. If I go for minimizing, observe. Around the flex lines also, it is going to provide the space. See, observe, there is a difference between the space between the flex lines. Yeah. That is the advantage of align content. If you don't want like space around or space between, if I would like to align with respect to flex start or flex end, I can go for always do like that. Observe, always it will append to the flex start. I don't want like that. Always I need to append to the flex end. Observe, always append to the flex end. That is the advantage of this align content. Okay, fine. If you go for next kind of property, this is the last property. Yeah, justify content is a property which is meant for to align the items. This is also used for to align the items relating to main axis, not with respect to cross axis. Whereas coming to align items property is meant for to align the items related to cross axis, whereas justify content is going to relate it to the main axis, Okay, fine. So it supports various kind of values: center, flex start, flex end, space around, space between. So it is the same meanings of the align content properties. So observe, I hope if you go for that property instead of align comment, align content, yeah, to make avoid confusion, I'm going to comment. So I'm going to justify the content. Justify the content, I'm going to make it as a center. See, this also I will make it as first comment. This is also comment. Observe what the output does. Yeah, fine. What happened, guys? It is going to by default stretch up to the container height. So because we didn't define whether it is a stretch or whether it is a center, that we need to define with respect to align items, right? Yeah, fine. So I will go with here as center. Then it will modify its structure. Yes. Now I would like to justify the content with respect to main axis. Up to now, align items were meant for with respect to cross axis. Now with respect to main axis, if you would like to arrange, then I can go for that justify content. So that is the reason it is going to align in the form of center. Yeah. Fine. If you would like to go for flex dot means you know the meaning. Yeah, starting onwards it is going to arrange. If you go for flex end, it will comes under the main axis this side. And space between, you know, for all the sides it is going to provide the space. You observe main axis, all the elements, it will provide a space around the elements. Flex item left side, right side, as well as all the elements is going to provide a space. Stretch, what will happen? Yeah, like this it will be. I can go for this is space between. I can go for space around also. Yes, observe. So like this we can justify our content with respect to main axis also. Yeah, so like this you can play with all these kind of properties to arrange your items. Yeah, one important thing here is the main advantage of this one is we can go for various kind of real time examples. Among those, for example, when you open your web browser, when you open your website in a particular browser where its width is larger, then I can go for my navigation bar horizontally. If I open the same navigation bar in a small screen, then how I need to arrange my flex item, I need to arrange my navigation bar, I need to arrange this in the form of a vertical. Then what I can do simply, I can define this larger screens, I can define this display as flex, and I can define the flex direction as row. This is by default. For small screens, what I will do, with help of media query, I will find out the screen size, and I am going to convert into form of a display flex property, and I am going to define the flex direction as column. This is the way simply we can do a real time example with the help of this flex box. Yeah, but in the previous classes I have used this media query to convert this horizontal navigation bar into vertical navigation bar with the help of float property and some kind of width, all those. Yeah. But thing is, here it is very very simple. By just making use of the property called flex direction property, we can do that. Yeah. So this is all about the flex container. In the next class, we'll see what do you mean by flex items and the properties of flex items and various kind of examples. So I hope you understood clearly. Thank you.